day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Amen.
Amen. And welcome to worship as we celebrate the baptism of our Lord this morning. We're glad that you could be joining us at home. We begin with the brief order for confession and forgiveness. And blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who stretches out the heavens, who sends light to the nations, who gives breath to us all.
Amen.
Amen. And now let us confess our sins in the presence of God and of one another. Loving God, we confess that we have turned from your way to follow our own ways. Forgive us for the times we have spoken or acted too quickly. We have not spoken or acted at all. We have hurt those closest to us. We have hurt those we have yet to know. We have thought more about ourselves than others. We thought less of ourselves than we ought. Turn us around and give us a fresh start so that we can live again as your children. Amen.
Amen.
Even when we have done wrong, God makes us right. Even when we have messed up, God puts us together. God's love never runs out. God never tires of calling us beloved children. Hear God say to you now, your sins are forgiven for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
Amen. And now may the peace of the Lord, a peace that surpasses all human understanding, be with you all. Let us share God's amazing peace with one another. Peace. First reading this morning comes to us from the book of Genesis. beginning in the first chapter, in the first verse. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep. While a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. And then God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. And God saw the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And the second reading comes to us from the book of Acts, in the 19th chapter, also beginning in the first verse. While Apollos was in Corinth, Paul passed through the interior regions and came to Ephesus, where he found some disciples. And he said to them, "Did you receive the Holy Spirit when you became believers?" They replied, "No, we have not even heard there is a Holy Spirit." And then he said, "Into what then were you baptized?" And they answered, "Into John's baptism." Paul said, "John baptized with the baptism of repentance, telling the people to believe in the one who was to come after him, that is, in Jesus." On hearing this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. And when Paul laid his hands on them, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and they spoke in tongues and prophesied. Altogether, there was about 12 of them. The word of the Lord. And our gospel this morning comes to us from St. Mark in the first chapter. John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And the people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him and were baptizing him in the River Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair and a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. He proclaimed, "The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. And just as he was coming out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart and the Spirit descending like a dove upon him. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." This is the gospel of our Lord. I greet you with the grace, peace, mercy, and love poured into our lives by God our Creator and our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. Amen. There's a lot of different ways we could go with these texts today. But putting into the context of where we are in this season of Epiphany, when Jesus and God in Christ Jesus is revealed to us, I think I want to take a little different direction than maybe we have in the past. Our first lesson is at the beginning of creation, before there was nothing. And God spoke creation into being. God spoke creation into being. God's actions, God's words are not merely a dialogue, but God is action. God's words make things happen. And that's what happened. And there was light. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. We'll get back to the Acts reading, because it's important. It's important for a particular reason, but I want to go back to that for a second. So with the gospel, John the Baptizer is doing his thing. He's out there in the wilderness. He's baptizing people in the River Jordan. This text has such a close association with the ancient text that we hear in the Old Testament. First of all, John was dressed with camel hair, with a leather belt wrapped around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. That just didn't just happen to be. This was the uniform worn also by Elijah, the great prophet. And in Malachi, prophesied that the word would come again, and that prophecy is fulfilled in John the Baptizer when he, like Elijah, is proclaiming that the kingdom of God has come near. John is baptizing. People coming out into the wilderness from all the Judean countryside and all of Jerusalem. This is a big event. Coming out to a place that no one would dare to go to for any other reason other than to be in community with God and with God's people. See, God doesn't come in to the temple and hold court. Quite the contrary. Jesus was born in a stable. John is in the wilderness, the least likely places to find God is just exactly where we find God and where God finds us. Unpresumptive, ordinary people going out to have a baptism for the forgiveness of sin, confessing their sin. It's time to be truthful. It's time to admit all those things that we have done wrong so we can be in perfect union with God in Christ Jesus. That's what this is about. Not so much about Jesus being baptized, but the entire event of what's happening. And then there's one phrase that after Jesus came out of the water, the heavens were torn apart. Torn apart. And the Holy Spirit descended like a dove upon him. And the voice of God again, in action, this, you are my son, my beloved, with you I am well pleased. He said to him, essentially, we did this. We've witnessed this. Now go out. And you changed the world. We got this started. But the heavens were torn apart. God is on the loose. God comes out of that torn apart heaven like a Holy Spirit descending like a dove to be in our lives. This Holy Spirit is something so important in our lives today, because this is what we have to guide us along our pathways, to guide us when things are falling apart, to keep us moving forward. And when these people came before Paul and before Apollos and said, we don't know anything about the Holy Spirit. We were baptized with water. Baptized by the Holy Spirit is the real deal. It's not just for the forgiveness of sin, as the baptism by water was, but it's bringing us into communion with God in Christ Jesus. It's making us one of the family so that we can abide in God and God then can abide in us. Because sisters and brothers, God is on the loose. Right now, in our lives, God is doing amazing things, beyond what we can even imagine as we suffer and complain about the events of the pandemic and all the isolation and our world's turned upside down. God saying, you know what? I'm here. I'm here. I'm with you in the wilderness. I'm with you in the manger. You don't need a church to know who I am and where I am. The fact that we are not meeting as church does not stop God from being on the loose. God's with us wherever we go. In the manger, in the wilderness, in church, in every step of our lives, God is with us. Rejoice. Don't complain. God has not abandoned us through this most difficult time that we have suffered. God is with us, walking every step with us. God, Almighty God, is on the loose. And thanks be to God. Amen.
Amen.
Saturday night at 8 o'clock, Deacon Susan Kranz is leading us in our prayers. So that's why we're not doing them on Sunday morning. So I invite you to tune in on our Facebook page. It's live. And I thank Susan again for taking on that task. Gathered in by God's Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Just one short announcement today, with a very important one. Happy birthday to Frank Rizzo this week, coming up. Prayers for our sister Linda Burns, who will be undergoing surgery this week. So please keep Linda. She's been a visitor here for quite a number of times. So keep Linda in your prayers as well. And And now may the Lord bless us and keep us. The Lord make his face to shine upon us and be gracious to us. The Lord look upon us with favor and grant us peace.
Amen.